Welcome on this beautiful September Sunday. We have game two of the Reading Rockets Pop Warner A football team here. They're 1-0 after their victory against Chelsea last week. We're at home today on a gorgeous day in the high 70s, sunny, playing a Westford team that's 0-1 after losing to Drake it last year. This is Josh Blumenschein, your play-by-play host. I'm here with on the camera, the excellent ex-slam ball, professional slam ball player, Adam Hooker. And we're glad to bring you this game today. Reading Rockets, they're led by Coach Bob Geiger, and down in the Tennessee hat, Coach Dave Irwin, a little Rocky Top in order here. As Reading's ready to go here today. They're gonna drive the control both offensive and defensive line, control the line of scrimmage. The offensive line, of course, centered by big number 84, Chris Tooley, who was centered on all their sets. Last week, they had four different players score. A lot of Reading Rockets will touch the ball today, we imagine, against Westford. On defense, play tough gap control and let the linebackers, defensive ends, really clean things up, make the plays. So it looks like the coin flip has been completed here. Westford's going to receive the ball, going from right to left on your screen. Reading Rockets getting set to kick off here to start the game here. Number 43, Christian Trauger, tees it up. Referee blows his whistle. Game is set to get underway. And there's the kick. It's a squibber on the left-hand side. It's going to stay in bounds. Yes, it does. Oh my, it was almost recovered by the Rockets before going out of bounds at about the 26-yard line. So Westford will start with the ball. Back for the Reading Rockets today is big number 64, Jay Kajander, who had missed the first game due to injury. He's out there on the line along with number 40, Thomas Keene. We have on the outside there, number 44, Jason Conroy. Number 14, Vinny Sullivan, Vincent Sullivan, who breaks all the Rockets' huddles, breaks it down for him. He's also in the A-gap. On the far side end, we've got Colin DuRoss, number 22. Westford lines up three wide receivers split left. The run, and he is met immediately. The ball is loose. Rockets got the ball. Ben Mason flashed through. Knocked him 8 yards back in the backfield and recovered the fumble. So the Rockets will take over at the 22. Well, after that first play for Westford, it reminded me of Jadeveon Clowney breaking through against Michigan a couple years ago in the bowl game. Ben Mason hit him in the backfield. But now Reading comes out on offense with Brendan DeSilva, number 10 at quarterback. Split receivers left and right, two each way. Dan McGrath. Here's the snap. Brennan follows the block. Up in the big hole. He's got room to run. He breaks to the outside. He's in for the touchdown. Reading Rockets on the board. Just 30 seconds into the game. 6-0. Lines up for the kick. Christian Trauger's got it up in the air and through. The 2-point extra point is good. 8-0 Reading Rockets. Well, Reading has quickly put up 8 points on the board. Here we go, kicking off again, right down the middle. Number 14 picks it up for Westford. He's pinned off by DuRoss. He's able to corral him there at the 21-yard line. That's where Westford will take over. Here we go, first and 10 for Westford at the 21-yard line. They all check their armbands. Coaches call on the play, and they all have the plays on their armband. They come in tight under center for the quarterback. There's a snap. He rolls out. Kajander chases him. He's pushed out 21 by Ben Mason, the line to gain. So there's a no gain on the play. Lucas Lorenz at 24 running in here for Ben Mason. Oh, the ball's on the ground. Chased by Jake Janner. He's down at the 13-yard line. So now it's third and very long for Westford. About 18 yards to go. Motion for number 87. The jet sweep handoff. He gets to the outside, but no, he's brought down immediately by BJ Jemelara, number 7. He was about to break that for a long gainer, but instead lost a half a yard. Bring up fourth down and 18. Westford to punt here. It's actually fourth and 20. Brendan De Silva's back deep at the 32-yard line. Almost blocked by Colin Duros. Ball's on the ground. It appears that Westford has it. Brendan could not corral the punt. Westford ball at the 26-yard line. Right down the A gap, we got 32, actually the B gap, Dominic DiCrescenzo. 23, Matt Gorman's A gap. And he's brought down on a sack. Number 64, Jay Kajander. As a defensive end, he just flashed into the backfield. Last play. Oh, he's brought down again by Colin Duros. Westford's going backwards. Many more plays have lost yardage than gained yardage at this point. Adam, I just want to point out, coach requires the bench to call out pass plays, and when they don't, he has them doing burpees over on the sideline during the in-between plays. I like that. The discipline for the Reading Rockets. Third down now in 23. Westford's having a challenge blocking our defensive line right now. Motion for 19. There's the snap. He's going to throw. It's a screen play. 19's got it. The first man there, number 44, Jason Conroy, drags him down, bringing up fourth down and long. Westford ready to punt now. Fourth and long. Brendan De Silva back deep again, with BJ and Conroy as the up man, I'm sorry, McGrath. And the snap is over his head, and he recovers it at the 4. He's tagged down there by Colin Duros. Reading will take over at the 4-yard line. Reading breaks the huddle. First and goal from the 7-yard line. Duros is in the backfield with Christian Trauger, number 43. The snap is over Trauger's head. And ball is on the ground. Looks like Westford may have it. They have it at the 23. Here we go. First down for Westford. And it's a jailbreak. And he's brought down by one of the many, looks like DiCrescenzo, number 32. Waves of black and red in on that quarterback on that play. And as it can say, Westford's having a hard time with offensive line blocking these guys. Second down and 18. Adam, they're employing the blocking style called lookout blocks. 14 drops back. He, again, Black right there with him. He's brought down by number 10, Brendan De Silva, at the 9-yard line. He is running for his life back there, number 14. Third down and long. As a defensive lineman, there's nothing more fun than a free run towards a quarterback. Doesn't even see you. There's a pass play. Pressure again. He's brought down at the 3. Oh, 3 of guys there. Ben Mason was there. Colin Duros, number 22. Fourth down and very long as Westford looks to punt. Fourth and forever for Westford. They're in a formation like they're going to throw the ball. And they pass on a draw or run on a draw. Hit by DiCrescenzo. He breaks out of that first one. BJ wraps him up. And they're able to tackle him at the 13-yard line, which is where the Reading Rockets will take over. It's been stout so far. They haven't had very many plays on offense. They break the huddle here. 3 in the backfield, McGrath, Duros, and De Silva. Chris Julie snap to Duros. He pitches to Brendan De Silva, follows an army of blockers. and he's in for the touchdown. There on the sweep there, Ben Mason and Dan McGrath cleaned everything up and still had all room to run. So it's 14-0 Reading Rockets. For the extra point, Reading's going for one here. Same formation as before. There's the snap. Oh, it's a keeper. Colin pulls out himself. He throws. He's got DiCrescenzo for the touchdown. The extra point, I should say. 15-0 Reading Rockets. Do Ross DiCrescenzo on that pass. So that's the end of the first quarter with a score 15-0. To start the second, Reading kicks right to left. Good boot by Trauger right down to the 20, the 30-yard line. Taking it to 20. He's tiptoeing. He's not looking for a hole. Colin DeRoss is there, but he slips that one. Brendan DeSilva pushes him out at the 10-yard line. The challenge with some of these blowout games is that it doesn't prepare you for the stiff competition. I know the Reading Rockets are getting ready for Everett next week. That'll be a tough game, is highly anticipated. So hopefully Westford can put up a bit more of a fight here in the second period. In now at linebacker for BJ is Trevor Zupan, number 65. Outside corner on the left is number 8, Jared Panucci. The right cornerback is number 44, Jason Conroy. He's back to pass. He slips the blocker, tackle, and he makes a little run. He's still on his feet. Jason Conroy brings him down at the 37. Westford's first down of the game and a big gainer as he got past the initial rush. First and 10 for Westford now. Shotgun formation, 37 motions right to left. There's the snap. He's setting up the screen, but it's too late. DeRoss comes through and sacks him again. He spent a lot of time in his back today on the 47-yard line there for Westford. Second and 18 now for Westford. There's the snap. He's looking to pass. He can't find anybody, and he's sacked again by DeRoss. That must be four sacks for him today. It's like they never block him. Third down now for Westford, and about 30. There's a snap direct. He takes the run outside. He's got some room on the end, on the side there. Being chased by Panucci, brought down at the 29-yard line. They are back in business with fourth down and two at the 29-yard line of the Reading Rockets. Good tackle by Panucci out there on the end. Westford adjusted to all the outside pressure from the defensive end and were able to slip in underneath it with a running play. Fourth and two here. There's the snap. He's got a hole. He gets down at about the 20. He's got the first down. Westford's second first down. For Westford now, they're scrapping the passing game for quarterback runs. There's the pass. Going deep. Out of the reach of 87. In coverage there is 65, Trevor Zupan. That'll bring up second down. Second and 10 for Westford. There's the snap for 14. Kajander chases him, and he's tackled by DeRoss. Also there, Vincent Sullivan, number 15. 14. Third down. Third down and 15 now for Westford. There's the snap. And the handoff, the draw play, he's brought down by a host of tacklers. Number 7, BJ, finishes him off. 23, Matt Gorman was the first one there. That brings up fourth down. Four down territory here for Westford on the 22-yard line of Reading. Fourth down, number 70, Zach Barbo's in there in the A-gap. The ball's on the ground, and he's down, and Reading will take over a bad snap. You got to complete that snap. And on the 26-yard line, the Reading Rockets will take over. So Westford had a little bit of something going on there, but not enough, not even sniffing the end zone. And Rockets ball. Rocket ball from the 20. They got to march 80 yards for a score. They've had the ball on Westford's side the whole game so far. There's the ball. Snap, the number 12, Dan McGrath, follows the blockers. He breaks to the outside, a stiff arm on number 30, and gets first down yardage, maybe a half a yard short. See where they spot it at the 34. Second and one, Reading Rockets. There's the snap, the handoff to Brennan De Silva. Follows his blockers. Good patient running. He slips through. He's over midfield. A stiff arm. He can't stay in bounds, but he gets to the 32. A great pickup for Reading Rockets. Waiting for his blocks to be established and then breaking through the hole. After the timeout, Reading Rockets ball. Jack Blumenschein in the backfield with Trevor Zupan. Matt Hammond split out wide to the right. Trevor follows the block. He gets in through the hole. He breaks out to the outside. He's on his way. He could go. He's down at the 12-yard line. Big gainer for Trevor Zupan, the only player on the team from Wakefield, actually. First down, Rockets. First down. Snap to Jack Blumenschein. He follows the block. He breaks outside. He's got 8 yards or so on the carry. Second down, Rockets. Reading Rockets. Zach Barbo at left tackle. Left wing back is Jason Conroy, number 44. Zupan in the backfield with Blumenschein. Zupan takes it to the outside, follows a block. He's up in there. He's got a positive gainer of maybe 3. I don't think he got the first down. Third down. Third and one. Matt Hammond split out wide right. Snap from Chuli to Blumenschein. He follows a hole. He breaks up in there. He's in for the touchdown. Jack Blumenschein makes it 21-0 Rockets. So excellent blocking that time. Some of the guys on the line, number 32, DeCrescenzo, Evan Long wing back, made some good blocks. Zach Barber, Chris Chuli at center. Looks like Reading's going to go for one on the extra point. Lucas Lorenz at number 24. He's right guard. Zupan and Blumenschein in the backfield. There's the snap to Zupan. He follows through. He's got a big hole out of the right side. Good block by Matt Hammond. And he's in for the extra point. 22-0 Reading as we near the end of the first half. Here's the kickoff for Reading. Zupan gets on out there. Chargers ready to go, kicking from the 40. There's the boot in the middle. It's fielded on a knee, and he covers it up at the 31, 32-yard line. Westford got a first down on that first play. They're spread wide again here. First down, 14, hands off on the inside hand up to 34. He's brought down by Ben Mason. And could gain a 2. Second down and 7 for Westford. I think there's about 30 seconds left in the half. They just called the timeout. 87 motions. They give it to him on the sweep. He gets outside DeCrescenzo. Crosses midfield. He's brought down there by number 9, Evan Long. Nice tackle. He took on the big fella. They got a first down in the play, though. Around the 45-yard line. There's the snap. 14 goes back to pass. He completes it to 87. He's brought down by Dan McGrath immediately for a gain of about 5. Dan tried to play the ball, but he stayed behind and was able to make the tackle on 87. I think that's the end of the half. So, at the end of the first half, it's been all Reading Rockets, 22-0 over visiting Westford. For the second half, Westford kicked to Reading. Back deep is De Silva and Gemellaro. There's the kick. It's a good kick. It's caught on the fly by Brendan. Slides to the left, misses one tackle. steps out at about the 39-yard line. Good field position for the Reading Rockets. Well, now with Matt Hammond, number 50, in the shotgun formation, taking the snap from the 40-yard line, first and 10. There's a snap. Hammond goes to the right, finds a hole, cuts it back in the middle, able to get it 2 yards on the play. Good play on first down. Leading the huddle now, number 23, Matt Gorman. He's got Matt Hammond, number 50, back there with him. Trauger split out wide right. There's the snap. It gets past Matt Gorman. He falls on it. Looks like Reading recovers at the 29-yard line. Third and 20 as Reading breaks the huddle. Trauger split out wide right. There's a snap to DeRoss. Looks like we had a little movement from Reading. So that'll back him up 5 yards. Third and 25 now from the 25. Third and 25. Reading Rockets trying to salvage this drive. DeRoss for the snap. He takes it, pitches to Brennan De Silva. He's got room to run. A big block by Dan McGrath. He slips one tackle. The help by Mason, and he gets the first down, and he's out of bounds over midfield at the 46. Good downfield blocking by Ben Mason, and Dan McGrath helps spring Brendan for about a 30-yard gain. Jared Panucci, number 8, in with the play. Zupan's in the back there with him from the 50. There's the snap. Panucci is able to get 5 yards on the carry, so he bobbled it for a second, but recovered to fall forward for 5. Folks, we're running out of tape here today on this game. You might not get the whole game in its entirety. Second and 6 from the 46-yard line. Christian Trauger split out wide left. The snap to Zupan, pops up in the air. Panucci falls on it. Having some problems with guys who don't receive the snap all the time, not catching them cleanly. So now that'll bring up 3rd and 12. 3rd and 12 for Reading now. There's the snap. Rolling out to the left. Jared Panucci getting to the outside. 34 gets a hit on him. Still on his feet, gets down to the 44-yard line, drags forward for 4th down and 4. Nice pickup of 8 yards by Jared Panucci. 4th and 5 now, Panucci in the backfield with Zupan. Colin Ross, the right wing back. There's the snap, they pull to the right. He's got a big hole, he breaks through. He's got first down yardage, 7 yards. Nice blocking on the right side, Ben Mason in there. First and 10 now. Matt Hammond there to receive the snap. He's hit right at the line, able to fall forward for a yard or two. Second down. Second and 8. Jared Panucci came running in with the play. Official made him tie his shoelace. It reminds me of Denard Robinson, who they used to call shoelaces over there at Michigan. There's the snap. Panucci rolls out to the left. He's got Matt Hammond with a lead block. Fouling Ben Mason, fouling B.J. Gemellaro, breaks an arm tackle, thrusts through, still on his feet, dragged out at the 7-yard line. He must have shed 3 tacklers on that play. Here we go for Reading Rockets, 1st and 10 from the 15-yard line. Lorenzo in the backfield, everyone jumps along the right-hand side of the line. 1st and 15. Adam, how many burpees are the team up to after these 2 false start penalties?
I'm guessing at least 50.
10 or 50. Lorenzo with the handoff, runs right into the defensive end, 21. He's able to fall forward for a yard or two. 2nd down. Second down and 14 as they break the huddle. Lorenzo and De Silva in the backfield. Snap from Chuli. Hand off to Lorenzo. Over the right-hand side, he cuts it up between the tackles. He's able to pick up about five on the play, bringing up third down. Third down and seven now for the Reading Rockets. Basila hands to Lorenza up in the hole. As he's fighting for yards, we got a scrum. Look at the Reading Rockets push Westford down the field. Is he in for a touchdown? He is. Lucas Lorenza, number 24, makes it 28-0 Reading Rockets. A team effort as they just scrummed and pushed Westford into the end zone.